Hey everybody, it's Carlene the Pink Scrapper, and today I'm doing some watercoloring on a little canvas purse that I got. And I've had this for a while. I've kind of just forgotten about it and had it in the back of my mind, and so I thought I'd play with it today. What I think I want to do is I'm going to put some of this watercolor on the canvas and then let it dry and then stamp this really pretty butterfly. And this is made by Inka Dinka Doo, and I was going to stamp it in one of these colors depending how the watercolor looks. So one of those purples. I might have to change the color, and so let's get started. I'm a little worried, but we'll see how it comes out. Okay, in this watercolor set, I think I just got it at the dollar store. It's 8 Vibrant Colors by Colorific. And on the side here, you might not be able to see it, I have a paper towel or kitchen towel and a diaper wipe. So I think I'm going to start with orange. And we're going to get it pretty wet. Get this started. Alright, so I'm going to just put some color on here. You know what? I probably should spray this first. Hang on a sec. So let's spray this. Kind of douse it. I'm going to also paint that little handle there. Okay, so now I think I'm ready. Okay, so let this just dribble on. Pretty orange color. I don't think I've played with watercolor since I was little, so this is kind of fun. I love that orange on there. It's pretty cool. Okay, so let's go with something else. Getting a little brave here. There's a purple. So let's do some purple. Get that really watery in there. Okay. Remember, I've got two sides. I think I want to do the handle purple too. Well, that came out really cute. Okay. Let's keep at it. I'm going to put more color on there. And I haven't decided what kind of sealer to put on here. So I know there's a fabric sealer. I just don't know what it's called. Just to seal it. This project probably can't go in the washer. Okay, there's another little spot in there I've got to get, and let's go for orange. That orange and purple is pretty combo. I think I need to spray it again with some water. Alright, so too bad this isn't Ustream. You can tell me what colors to put on here and help me out. I'm going to just fill in the yellow with in the little holes here. And my brush is falling apart, but that's okay. I think I can pull those off. There's little brush hairs. And I'll probably come back and put more purple on there. Okay, so there's one side. I'm going to flip it over and do the other side. And I'll let it dry, and then I'll come back and show you how it looks when we're ready to stamp. Okay, we're back. And okay, so don't laugh at my little contraption here. I realized that when I'm going to stamp on this, I'm going to need some cushion in there. And so I stuffed one of my old kitchen Christmas towels in there. So you can see I use that and just rewash it and use it over. But so that is how hopefully I get a good impression of my butterfly. And then here, let me lift this up. on here, I put some acrylic paint. And this is Folk Art Violet Pansy. And I just use my skewer and I kind of just spread it all over there. So, and it looks like it's getting a little dry. So I'm going to go ahead and try to do this quickly. So I'm stamping my butterfly, trying to get it covered really well. Okay, looks good. I'm going to stamp off a little bit, and now I'm going to come in here and give it a try. And I'm kind of rocking it so that I get it on there. And it looks pretty good. Okay. So, what I'm going to do is get my heat gun and dry that up a little bit, and then we'll do the other side. Okay, I dried the first side. Now I'm going to stamp second butterfly. And this one is pretty gooey, so there's too much. I'm going to stamp off onto my diaper wipe over here. Try to get some of that off so I can get a clean stamp. Okay, and then I'm going to stamp at a different angle, I guess, and push it down. And I am rocking it. Okay, ta-da! Cool. So that came out pretty good. I'm gonna dry this side, and while I was looking around, I found some pearl bling from Prima, and so I put some on the other side already, and I'm going to put this, whoops, on this side. And I kind of noticed it's not very sticky, and this was the E-line, so I don't know what happened, but it's kind of disappointing, and I don't use this very often, so let's see, maybe we can stick it. I kind of like that, and I probably have some extra that I'll just cut off. So it's not sticking too well to my cloth, so I think when I Mod Podge it, it should be okay. Because that'll protect it a little bit. So let me dry this side, and I'll show you the other side. Just a second. Okay, and I did forget to tell you that it needed some glitter, so I pulled out my, what is this one called? Walnut, gold walnut from Tattered Angels. And I went ahead and I sprayed the other side as well. So you probably can't see the bling on camera, but I can see it here. It's really pretty. Okay, I'm back with my finished product. And this is my butterfly canvas coin purse. And I really liked the colors and how it came out. I'm going to kind of tilt it so you guys can see different angles of it. You might not be able to see the glimmer mist, but it's got some sparkles in it. And the Mod Podge, let me show you. This is the Mod Podge that I used. It's the Glossy Luster. And it says on the back of the bottle that you can use it for fabric. So it's a really good protector. And I think it came out really cool. So thanks for watching and have a great day.